reference, and then we can have a look later. Okay, yeah, if you haven't met me before, yeah, there you go. I'm Jackson Felden. My email is there. If you want to later on send me, you know, some emails, hopefully I'll be able to help you. If you want to connect my LinkedIn, yeah, is there linkedin.com and then IN Jackson Felden altogether. I'll be happy to connect with you. Okay. Okay, just a bit of a little bit about my background. Let's say maybe some of you have been kind of following the Microsoft steps like me. I started my career in 1991 with MS-DOS 3.1, as far as I can remember. And then my first experience, a heavy experience, was on top of Novell. At this stage, I can't count how many servers and how many, let's say, classes I have delivered on that. And then in 1996, it was my first big movement to Microsoft, where I started studying, when I started studying NT. And yeah, and then pretty much, as you can see, I've been following Microsoft technologies since then. Office 365, my first experience was around 2012. In Azure, kind of 2014, 2015. Now I'm kind of working quite heavily on that. And then apart of that, Exchange and SharePoint and other bits and pieces as well. Okay. Anyway, the plan for this next hour is to explore the site recovery from Azure, and then I will give you some information on how you could basically migrate as well, but let's say do the replication from Hyper-V to Azure. And then later on between VMs between different regions on Azure and VMware as well. When you understand how to migrate VMware to Azure, you can, let's say for physical servers, it kind of uses the same structure as well. Okay, hopefully you like. As well, if you still have time for, there are a couple of other webinars coming up. Basically, yeah, the next one is on next week, I believe, yeah, 5th of September, is all about basically backup. Okay, usually I've been teaching for Microsoft a kind of one-day seminar or one-day kind of, you know, hands-on stuff on the disaster recovery and backup. And then basically the second part from today is going to be a backup next week. And then a very nice one on Office 365, some kind of features for GDPR. And then my colleague David on September 21st will run a nice PowerShell session. And then I'm back again for Azure AD. There are loads of things we can talk on that particular subject. And then finally, the last one is some kind of migration strategies to Azure. Let's say the kind of the good news, we decided to give you a voucher for just to make sure after today you can, if you haven't done any big work on Azure, and then you can go do a registration. Basically, our team will send you an email later on with the instructions and the most important kind of product key, and then you can register a free Azure. You don't need credit card, don't need anything, and then from there you will have access to 85 euros or 30 days of use, whatever kind of, you know, whatever comes first, whatever goes first, I would say. Okay, and then, yeah, just, you know, stay, please, connected. And at the end, we will send you some kind of more information how to do the registration on that. Then you can take advantage. If you are using Azure as well, yeah, that would be nice to create a different subscription just to make sure when you are doing some tests, you are not messing up with, you know, things you have already in place. Okay, anyway, finally, now we can start talking specifically about Azure Site Recovery. If you have some questions, I would say you could type on the chat box, you know, straight away, or if you want to keep at the end of the presentation, then we can have a chat on that as well. Yeah, that's, you know, no problem at all. Okay, when we are talking about site recovery, basically there are two components. The first one I'm going to explore today is the site recovery, as I will explain in better details in a few minutes. But mainly the idea is to replicate some of your physical servers and some of your virtual machines to Azure. And then eventually, if something goes wrong or very kind of wrong on your on-prem, yeah, you can do the failover and then have those VMs starting or running from Azure. And the second part, that's going to be a one-hour seminar next week, is for backup. And then, you know, as the name suggests, basically is to take a copy from, yeah, same story, can be only files or could be a full kind of a content between Azure regions or, again, from your local server or local kind of data to Azure as well. But we will talk about that next week. Okay. The two main scenarios here is the first one, as you can see the little picture there, and please remember we will send you those slides later on, is where you have a couple of physical servers or maybe some virtual machines running on VMware or virtual machines running on Hyper-V. And then the idea is to replicate them to Azure. And if something goes wrong, you can quickly and easily you can start them on Azure. I have two or three slides at the end of the presentation. Of course, guys, it's not like a magic. You just push the button and everything is up and running, because you need to be on top and you need to test first to understand, of course, how your workstations will be able to reach the servers that before they were running locally on your particular VLAN, and then eventually now they are running from Azure. And then, of course, you know, the whole routing table and VPN or express router, of course, the workstations, they must eventually to reach the servers in order for the users to keep kind of on top working on your company. And then, yeah, there is a bit of design on that, and some people, sometimes they get lost. What I can tell you now, and there is a better picture coming up later, is if you have your servers already running from a particular VLAN in a kind of, you know, different network, and then it's much easier for you to do the switch over and make sure the users can connect the servers now running from Azure, yeah, it's easier. If you have the servers running on the same subnet from where the workstations are connected, the same kind of IP range, yeah, then things are a little bit more more complicated. But yeah, I have two slides at the end of the presentation for us to talk about that. And then the second picture, as you can see, the idea here is to basically, yeah, just do the replication from different regions. Yeah, and, you know, not too likely for to have a catastrophe, for example, here in Dublin, and the data center to be kind of all unavailable. But yeah, we never know. If you really want to play safe, yeah, the idea is to have that data replicated to a different place. And then eventually, in a big catastrophe, yeah, we can do the failover for a different place. In my picture here, for example, to West Europe, that would be kind of, you know, Amsterdam. I forgot to tell you, just regarding the Skype for Business, if you look on the top right, there are two buttons. If you want to get rid of my picture there, you know, you don't need to keep looking at me. One of the buttons is the page layout, okay, or the pick a layout. Just basically click on that, and then if you select presented or presenter view, and then my picture will disappear. Okay, sorry about that. Yeah, and then you can get rid of my picture. And on the top right as well, the other option is to make a full screen. Okay, and then in a few minutes I will run a couple of quick demos, and then it will be kind of nicer. Okay. Yeah. Anyway. Okay. That's. Oh yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Here in on this picture, as you can see. I will explain better in a few seconds, but for now, what I want to say is if you are doing a physical server replication or a VMware replication, basically it works on top of a continuous replication. You know, as the name suggests, things are replicated kind of, you know, on real time. When you install the agent on a Hyper-V server, And then there are a couple of policies you can select. The lowest one is 30 seconds, and then the replication goes every 30 seconds, and 5 minutes and half an hour. There are a bit of variation on that. Yeah, anyway, that's because the agent that runs for Hyper-V and physical servers is basically different from the agent for Hyper-V. And to be honest, I checked these numbers last night just to make sure I was on top. And yeah, it has been the same since last year. Yeah, kind of 30 seconds and continuous replication. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Here, I will show you in a few seconds as well how to do. We can set up a policy. Then you can decide if the replication, goes every couple of hours, or maybe you could do every 24 hours or so on. Okay, that's in the kind of very high level. Now, guys, to go a little bit deeper on the kind of technical stuff. Okay, before I start doing any replication or any policy configuration or things like that, the first thing you need to set up on Azure, on your subscription, is a Azure Site Recovery Vault. Okay, that's basically the main element. And then, as you can see in my quick presentation here, all the settings. Okay, settings means from where to where you are doing the replication, the templates, the policies, and later on, if you want to get a bit of information if the replication has been completed, or all the monitoring as well. All of these things are basically managed under the Site Recovery Vault. You can create a couple of them. Okay, the main one I will use here, I created on Amsterdam, on West Europe, just to get some stuff from Dublin and migrate, okay, to there. And then, of course, you can have a couple of them across, across the world. But yeah, in order to eventually to achieve the replication, to have a proper site recovery up and running, yeah, that will be the very first element that must be created. Okay, the site recovery vault. And again, in a few seconds, I will run a quick demo how to do that. Guys, the other very, very important thing is the capacity planner, because sometimes some people, they get too excited with the replication, virtual machine replication to Azure, and not doing any plan. Somebody could go there and enable maybe three or four virtual machines to do the replication in a kind of working time, 9 o'clock on Monday, in a kind of Monday, a very busy day. And what's going to happen is, yeah, the replication can easily kill, okay, your link. And then this is why, in a few seconds on my demo, you will see when you are actually setting up the recovery vault for the first time, not for the first time, sorry, every time when you are setting up, for example, replication for Hyper-V or replication for VMware or whatever, basically the system asks you if you have completed the capacity planner. And as I said, the idea here is to have a better estimation how much data you are about to replicate, and how, let's say, how good your link must be. Probably at this stage, you are wondering if you can control the amount of the bandwidth, how many things you can synchronize at the same time. Yes, it's not kind of straight away to do that, but of course, if you are worried and to set some kind of policies from the replication point of view, yeah, it's possible to do that, to set up a kind of bandwidth and stuff. But yeah, please remember, in a few seconds on my demo, you will see time by time the capacity planner coming all the time, because again, as I quickly said, it can be a disaster if you in a kind of poor link, if you're unable to do a replication, get kind of too excited and replicate too many things at the same time is complicated. Okay, guys, now the first thing here for me to explore is the Hyper-V replication to Azure. And as you will see at the end of this presentation, is much, much, much easier when we compare with Hyper-V. Yeah, this slide's a little bit kind of too many things here going on, but to be honest, it's not too complicated. The key thing is you need to basically follow a quick procedure in register. Just let me point out here, just a second. Basically, guys, you need to go to your Hyper-V host, okay? And then when you install the agent, that Hyper-V will be kind of visible on your Azure Site Recovery Vault. And then basically following a not too complicated wizard, you can, the Azure interface, can basically see the virtual machines running physically on that server. Okay, in this case here, the virtual machine one, virtual machine two. And then it's just matter to select the virtual machine one at a time or a couple of, you know, of them at a time. Basically select them, provide a couple of more information, and then push the button to do the activation. And to be honest, the way it works is when the recovery service agent is installed on Hyper-V, that little agent uses the Hyper-V replication, okay, to replicate the virtual machines to Azure. I'm not sure if you have done any Hyper-V to Hyper-V replication. Actually, guys, just to kind of run a quick demo here and to kind of make things just one second, let me share my Hyper-V here with you. Okay, one second. Hopefully, sometimes it takes a couple of seconds for you to see what I'm sharing. You should get now, hopefully. Probably is loading. Okay, I believe now everybody can see one of my Hyper-V hosts. And actually, this is one of my kind of host kind of production, okay, Hyper-V. Guys, and then what I'm talking about is basically I have downloaded and installed the server. And I'm talking about this option here. Okay, if I go to this particular server 2012, where I'm running the AD Connect, right-click. And then, as you can see, enable replication. When you are implementing replication between two Hyper-V hosts, okay, this is the place where you go to do the configuration. In my case, I'm not going to touch any, not going to change any replication. And then on my next demo, eventually I will be able to see those virtual machines, and then I will be able to pick this one here in particular to do the replication to basically to Azure. Okay, yeah, and then the engine that Azure is using or Microsoft is using to do the replication is, let's say, two components. First, the built-in Hyper-V replication plus the Azure agent that kind of, you know, gives the option for us to replicate to Azure instead to replicate to a different Hyper-V server. Okay, just let me now run, share a window, one second here. Okay, guys, now let me share my window here, hopefully to run a quick demo on how can we enable, okay, a Hyper-V replication. Okay, again, probably is loading now for you. Okay, yeah, should get it now. Okay, anyway, guys, this is, to be honest, is not my Azure production environment. Okay, it's a little bit messy. This is my own subscription I'm using when teaching and, you know, just run some demos. And okay, now what I'm talking about is, just to be a little bit ahead of the schedule, I already created a recovery service vault, okay, here called West Europe Recovery Vault. Okay, and then when I click there, now, okay, there go, loads of things going on here. The most important for us to get things moving is basically this option here, okay, on the site recovery. Okay, and as quickly I told you at the beginning, this is the place as well where we go to do the backup, but let's leave that thing for next week, okay? Talking about site recovery, okay, the very first step is for me to decide infrastructure, okay? It means I want to do the site recovery between on-prem to Azure, or between Azure to Azure, or on-prem, let's say, data center one to on-prem data center two. Basically, here's the place where I need to decide, okay, what to do. On my case, for my quick demo, first demo, I want to get the on-prem, okay, and the destination is going to be, instead to be a other site recovery, no, it's going to be Azure. And now the options I have, there you go. First one is to a hyper, let's say from a Hyper-V or from VMware or from a kind of, physical server. Let's stick with the first one that is Hyper-V. Okay. Maybe not too popular, but some companies are using Hyper-V, or sorry, they are using System Center Virtual Machine Manager on top of Hyper-V, and then there is a variation on the configuration. On my case here in Dublin, I don't have too many virtual machines, and I'm not using. Okay, and then this is why I'm just setting here. Yeah, I don't have any System Center Virtual Machine Manager. Okay, that's fair enough. Click OK. Yeah, guys, this is the thing I told you a few seconds ago, because if you don't do a proper planning, you can easily enough to bring kind of, to overload your internet link very easily. And then, yeah, here every time when I'm setting up, basically Microsoft is asking me if I've done the proper planning or I will do later or so on. Okay, let's pretend I've done, everything is clear, I'm okay on top of that. Okay, then I click OK. Okay. Oh yeah, probably need to register my server again. Yeah, guys, basically here is the place. For example, if you are doing this procedure at the same time, what you need to do, as you can see on the top here, we have a Hyper-V site, and on the top right we have the Hyper-V server. Hyper-V site is very simple, as the name suggests. For example, let's say we have an office in Dublin, office in Galway, and I don't know, London. Yeah, then I would create here three sites with the Hyper-V servers under each of those sites. Okay, in my case, I have a particular only a single site, and then that's fine. Okay, if I want to add a new Hyper-V host where I want to get the VMs from there to and replicate to Azure. And then what I need to do is just click on that top corner, Hyper-V server. Click there. And yeah, there you go. And then here, guys, basically there are two options. Okay. On step number three, as you can see, is the agent. Okay. Here is the place where we download the agent. And step number four basically is the registration key. Because of course the agent, your local Hyper-V, needs to be able to, to reach your Azure subscription. And then the agent pretty much is kind of download, next, 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 finish, done. And then when you launch it for the first time, it requests the registration key. You just need to upload that file and then job done. And then, yeah, there you go. For example, under my Dublin office, I could have here, I don't know, five or six or 10 host server. And then I would add a new site called Galway, and then I would do the same to kind of add my, I don't know, three servers, servers in Galway. And okay, when, yeah, because last night I uploaded or I updated the registration agent on my server, now kind of, got disconnected. I can go back and just re-register again. Yeah, I saw a couple of times, I'm seeing a couple of times, if you can't see the server online, and then what you need to do is just run that procedure again, update the client, or in the worst case scenario, kind of, just do the registration again. Okay, yeah, anyway, when this procedure here is done, and then on the next step, you are able to basically list the virtual machines and then select the virtual machines and to start a replication. And when that thing is done, just let me switch here again, sorry. Okay, yeah, here. One second. Okay, guys. And then basically, when you pick the replication to be done, and then you will see on, as you can see, this VM here. Okay, if I click there, the replication is already on. I just paused because I didn't want to kind of compromise my link. But yeah, and then Azure will change the replication settings, and then from here you can have yeah, basically because I lost connectivity before, and then from here you will be able to see the replication is kind of running or not, and then for all the VMs it's up to you how many you want to do at the same time. Okay, just let me go back here, so just one second. Okay. Okay. Yeah, guys, this kind of big picture here with lots of things, but at the end of the day, that's the procedure. Basically, go to your Azure subscription. You need to create a site recovery vault. From there, you need to register your Hyper-V's hosts, and then finally, you'll be able to see the virtual machines, and you can decide which virtual machines, okay, you want to add. As I said before, it's kind of lots of text here, and I don't want to kind of go kind of step by step. I just left this thing here, and at the end, we will send to you. And then you can, later on when you do your own lab, your own test, and then you can follow, okay, you can follow the steps. But yeah, mainly, as I said, the starting point is to go to the prepare the infrastructure, and then from there you decide on-prem as source and Azure as destination, and then you select Hyper-V. Need to pick if you're using System Center or not. And then add your source location initially as a site, and then under each site you need to add whatever are your hosts. And yeah, there you go. And then guys, eventually you will see on step number three, okay, these are all the virtual machines available on my local host. Yeah, for example, the VM I was talking about, this is my own screenshot, Server 2012 AD Connect. Eventually select, and then as I said, when you do that, the replication status will become as active, and then replication starts, I would say straight away, but actually not, because when you are doing the setup, you can set a couple of replication policy, and then you can schedule, for example, the first replication, because that's the big one, to happens, I don't know, start 9 p.m. or maybe midnight or something like that, just to kind of not compromise your link. Guys, that's it pretty much. And eventually when you read kind of this information or some books, sometimes it kind of looks like very kind of complex and very complicated. But I would advise you to have your own testing environment before implementing your own company or implement for your customers. And yeah, you just need basically two things: a Hyper-V server with a couple of virtual machines and Azure subscription. This is why at the end of the presentation we will give you your free activation code. And then with those €85, you can kind of test a lot. Okay, is there any question, guys, on this first kind of section? How to migrate Hyper-V, or how to do the disaster recovery? And then, guys, the other, yeah, let's see how the time goes. But if I still have time at the very end, we can quickly talk about migration. And to be honest with you, the disaster recovery is the Microsoft best practice if you have planned to do any migration from on-prem to Azure. Because eventually you do the migration, sorry, you do the replication when the VMs are fully synchronized and fully kind of available on Azure, you do the failover, and then you can kind of finish the failover and set as migration completed. And then eventually the system will shut down your local virtual machine and will have the VM running on Azure. That's there is a seminar. Oh yeah, one of the seminars coming up, I think in October, is about migration, and then that's the time mainly when I will run a demo on that. But it's pretty much based on top of site recovery. Good stuff. Now the next thing is if you really want to play safe and have the site recovery between, let's say, two different data centers from Microsoft. Yeah, there you go. That's the place to do. Now, I think last year, some stage, they implemented some new features, and in these days, it's very simple for you to set up a particular virtual machine to be replicated and to be available in a secondary site, okay, when needed. Yeah. Anyway, let me show you. Okay, guys, the main thing I want to tell you is here. Okay, first of all, just a second, sorry. Okay. Guys, first of all, the first option is to do the whole configuration from the the virtual machine itself. Okay, this feature is quite new. I think last year or maybe 2 years ago they made it available. I will show you in 2 seconds. But basically, you just need to go to the virtual machine, and then from the virtual machine there is an option called disaster recovery. From there, you select the destination data center and a couple of OK and next, and then you know is job done. Or the second option, okay, is to do the whole kind of, you know, step by step using the recovery service vault. Okay, and then as I quickly did on my demo, instead to select source as on-prem, destination as Azure, mainly you just select as source Azure, destination Azure, and then, you know, follow a couple of steps, okay, to, you know, to have that. Okay. Yeah, guys, I have a couple of screenshots here, and then I can run a quick demo in 2 seconds. But yeah, guys, as I quickly said before, it starts from the place you already know. Okay, we need to go, in this case, from the recovery vault. Okay, and then from there, we select the prepare infrastructure first. And then under the prepared infrastructure, we select Azure to Azure. And then the second place is where I go to basically to here. Okay, and then I have the chance to say, oh yeah, what is my source location? And then what is going to be later on my destination location? Here again, okay, what's my source location, destination location? And then eventually the next screen will show you all the virtual machines. Yeah, please remember now I'm talking about the virtual machines running on Azure. All the virtual machines available on Azure. In my particular screenshot is a server 2012 US. Yeah, there you go. And then select what are the VMs or what is or are the VMs you want to replicate. And then the next screen, guys, if you are kind of new on Azure, initially it can be a little bit, you know, challenging, but you need to remember, if you are migrating, okay, if you are migrating a virtual machine, for example, from the Dublin data center to the Amsterdam data center, of course, back in Amsterdam, you need to select what is going to be your resource group. Okay, you need to set your target virtual network as well, because of course, you know, we can't have a virtual machine running without a network. And then, yeah, you need to have the virtual network there as well. And then you need to pick on the destination, what is your storage account, where, of course, that VHD will be created, and kind of, you know, other bits and pieces. When you basically select those things, and then you can push the button, and then eventually, it takes, of course, a while to do the replication. And then later on, if you go here on the left, I will run a quick demo. Okay, if you go to the disaster recover, okay, and then we can have a status, okay, showing up if the replication is done, is healthy, errors, you know, and things like that. Okay, the good news, guys, is when the replication is done, and in my pretend story, I'm doing here a replication, for example, from Dublin to the data center in Amsterdam, and then we have those options on the top. Okay, it's a little bit small. Hopefully you guys can read. Okay, failover and test failover. Yeah, maybe I think there is a slide at the end of my presentation, but why not for me to give you the tip of the iceberg now. Guys, the idea is, of course, you know, we should always test the failover before instead to wait for the time when things are complicated. And then the idea here is when you push the button and click on test failover, you will start the virtual machine in a testing network, okay, not on the production network. And then again, if you want to do that, you need to have two networks, okay, the production network with whatever is the IP range in the testing environment network, and then you will push that VM into the test environment. The VM will start there, Very important is when the virtual machine, now in my kind of scenario here, is running on the testing network in Amsterdam, the source virtual machine is still running in Dublin. Okay, because of course they don't talk to each other. They are running from two different networks, and there is no problem at all. And then eventually, I would test to see, oh yeah, the VM started. I was able to connect the VM. Okay, everything looks good. Okay, that's great. And then eventually, when the time comes, and if I need to do the real failover, yeah, there you go. And then that's the place or the button where we do there. And then if you click on the failover, eventually Microsoft will do all the checks, and the virtual machine running from the source data center will shut down, and eventually the virtual machine running from the disaster recovery data center starts, and then basically takes over from there. Okay, that's kind of the in a high level the way it works from Azure to Azure. And sorry guys, by the way, these options here on the top, okay, they are the same for Hyper-V and for VMware as well. Okay, when you have the Hyper-V and VMware up and running, or let's say fully replicated on the disaster recovery vault, and then yeah, it's up to you, and you should first do the testing, and then eventually when the day come, you can do the failover. Okay, to there. Okay, yeah. Okay, I don't have screenshots. I will run a quick demo now. Okay, guys, that would be the procedure when we go from the disaster recovery vault. But as I said, I think last year or maybe 2 years ago, Microsoft added this kind of option from the virtual machine itself. And then if I go there, let me just share here quickly. Okay, just one second. Okay, good stuff. Guys, now as you can see, I have here a bunch of virtual machines in front of me. Okay, here on the left, I just clicked on the virtual machines, and then I have a couple of them. And yeah, as I said, this is a kind of testing environment. Some of them are, as you can see, and under the location, okay, they are in US, other ones are in West Europe, Amsterdam, and I have other one here in Europe. Okay, that's fair enough. Now, guys, what I'm going to do is let me select a virtual machine called FS2 that is running from basically Amsterdam. Okay, if I click there, and then of course loads of things we could change here, disks and networking and loads of things. But I'm kind of looking now for disaster recovery. And if you connect back to my seminar next week, okay, we will talk about backup. But yeah, basically here is the disaster recovery. And then it means, guys, now, oops, just a second. Okay, now as you can see, I can select what is the target region. Okay, and then I have, please remember, I'm trying to replicate a virtual machine from, oh yeah, from Amsterdam. Okay, and then the options here is to replicate to North Europe, that means Dublin, okay, or France or UK, yeah, or the two places in UK. Let's say if I select to Dublin, oh yeah, guys, basically the demo subscription I have doesn't allow me to use Dublin, but if I get France, okay, France, I should be fine. Okay, yeah, there you go. And then basically, okay, I decided to send things to France. And guys, this is the beauty now of the wizard. In my case, I have two subscription. Okay, one is because I'm a Microsoft trainer. Other one because I belong to a Microsoft Gold partner. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Anyway, I'm selected here one of my subscription. Now I need to select resource group. And then as you can see, new. Guys, I don't have the option here to pick resource groups because I haven't done any kind of proper configuration in France. But if I would go, let's say, ahead of the schedule and set up the resource group, the availability group, the networking and everything in France before come to this option, and then I would have the options kind of, you know, ready to go. But, you know, the beauty of that is the only problem, you know, we don't have control for the names. But yeah, in the worst case scenario, Microsoft is creating for me a new West Europe Visual Studio, you know, ASR, okay, and so on. Yeah, anyway, and then I need to set up as well. Here I can set what's the replication settings and, you know, other bits and pieces. And then eventually I would just click on enable replication to, you know, start the replication straight away, or we can set the schedule, okay, to replicate things to there. That's it, guys, pretty much, okay? Basically, is you can achieve the same thing from two different places, okay? Go to the disaster recovery vault and do the configuration manually from there. Or if you are kind of looking to have this thing done as soon as possible in a particular virtual machine, you could go straight into the virtual machine and then have the configuration sorted, okay, from basically from there. Okay, let me now just run, show you something. Okay, let me cancel this thing here. Okay, guys, if I go back, to my West Europe Recovery Service Vault, okay, if I click there. Okay, and then, guys, if I go under the protected items, okay, and then backup and replicated items. Now, let me talk about replicated items. Yeah, there you go. I left on purpose, okay, three different status, okay, here. You know, the first one is a virtual machine called ESX VM1. Actually, that virtual machine was running in one of my VMware server, and then eventually I did the full failover, okay, to Azure. Okay, the second virtual machine, this server 2012 US, as you can see, is fully protected, okay, from East US 2, okay, and then I replicated to East US. And then the good news is, if I click basically here, okay, I can have a better understanding if there is any health issue or, you know, any problem with the replication itself. And then from here, basically, we will be able to see those buttons, okay, to test the failover. Yeah, there you go. And then, guys, yeah, that's a kind of, you know, nice nice picture, the virtual machine, okay, all the kind of, you know, the components in order to have that thing replicated. Yeah, the picture here is a little bit small, but as you can see on the map, because I'm replicating from East US to East US, okay, the buttons are, you know, the buttons are here. Okay, that's fine. And then, as I said here on the top, okay, this is the place for me to click and then eventually, you know, try to do the test failover. Okay, and after testing, okay, and then when I'm happy with the results, and then we could be ready to go when the time comes, okay, ready to go to do the failover when I click on the failover. Okay, yeah, there you go. Anyway, that would be, just let me go back to here, sorry, just a second. Okay. Anyway, that would be the quick demo when we are talking about how to do the replication between, you know, virtual machines between two different places from kind of, you know, Microsoft data center point of view. Guys, of course, I don't need to tell you loads of things can be done on PowerShell. Okay, just to make things more kind of visible and more easier, I'm using here the web interface. Okay. And then the kind of the last thing is for VMware. And guys, just to share my real life experience as well. Initially, when I started a couple of years ago studying site recovery, and then I kind of went through a couple of, you know, documents and books and stuff, and it was not really clear how the whole thing works, because it is a little bit more complex from when we compare with Hyper-V. And then the best advice I can give you is, again, you know, you have your own or you will have your own free subscription in okay, a few hours, hopefully. The best thing to do is to go ahead and do to create a lab yourself. Okay, what is different, guys, is this guy here called excuse me. Okay, is this guy here called configuration server, and basically the process server. And then the way it works is when you are doing the setup, you need basically download a VMware virtual machine that runs as a configuration server and process server. Okay, last time when I checked is a 22 gigs download, and the process is not too complicated. It's basically download that virtual machine, upload, or let's say not upload, kind of, import that virtual machine into your one of your VMware servers, and then start the virtual machine. A wizard will start asking you quite a lot of information. I have some screenshots here I will share in a few seconds. And then basically you need to finish that configuration. When you have the configuration server and the process server fully up and running and configured, yeah, there you go. And then you can go back to the web interface. And then finally, to see what are the VMware virtual machines available to start replication. And of course, guys, if you are kind of doing the disaster recovery for a quite big site with dozens or maybe hundreds or thousands of virtual machines, and then what you can do is to have a couple of configuration or especially process server. Okay, because the process server is basically the guy who does all the caching and the compression and everything before sending the data to Azure. And then, that thing could be too much for a single virtual machine. And then this is why we have more flexibility. You could spread that thing in different servers. Guys, same story. I'm not going to read all the kind of this text. I just left it for you to have a look later on as a reference. Bits and pieces regarding the components and the replication and ports and things like that. And yeah, if you look the step by step to have a replication done from VMware to Hyper-V, initially is a little bit, scary, but it's not too complicated to be honest. Okay, let me just pause and let me just show you the option. If I go here, just one second, guys. Sorry. Okay. Anyway, just to start kind of, from the scratch again, if I go back to my subscription and then just let me get this guy here again, my recovery vault. Okay, now the same place where I was before, site, okay, under the getting started, site recovery. And then under site recovery, I need to go now and set a goal. Okay, the goal is still on-prem to Azure, but now, yeah, before, hopefully you can remember, I picked Hyper-V. Now I'm looking for VMware. Okay, good stuff. Just let me select Hyper-V, sorry, VMware. Click OK. Yeah, as I told you before a couple of times, same story. Before I start any replication, I need to be on top of and kind of, understand how much data will be synchronized. Okay, good stuff. And yeah, there you go. Guys, same story. Okay, here is the place where basically you download the configuration server. Okay, I've done this a while ago. I don't have my VMware running, at the moment. My VMware vCenter used to call NH vCenter. But yeah, anyway, guys, if I click here, okay, configuration server, click there. Yeah, there you go. And then, guys, as you can see, now what I need to do is to download the configuration server. Okay, basically is a kind of virtual machine template. Last time when I checked, it was 22 gigs. And quickly, as I told you before, test the procedure. I need to download this virtual machine, import this virtual machine in one of your VMware hosts. And then, yeah, when you have that thing up and running, basically you will see your configuration server, okay, here, your host Hyper-V and configuration server from here. And then eventually, you select OK. And then from there, you are able And then from there, sorry, you are able to select the source virtual machines running from your VMware server. And same story. And then you can decide what are the VMs you want to eventually to do the replication. Just let me show you here, because I don't have time. Sorry, just a second. Let me switch back. Okay, guys, just to save a bit of save a bit of time. Basically, when you have the configuration server fully imported and up and running from one of your Hyper-V, from your one of your VMware server, and then really what you need to do is start that VM, and then the VM will start from the scratch, asking, okay, fair enough, what is the name of this computer? And then, that's fine. Of course, guys, here you need now, please remember, all the screenshots you are seeing now, they are from that configuration server I've downloaded from template, okay, from basically Azure. And then, of course, here I need to provide my Azure credentials. And then I need to decide what is my or which of my subscriptions I want to use, and then of course I need to decide as well what is the resource group and the very important, the recovery service vault. And as I said, here is just a summary, okay, but there are quite a lot of configuration to be done. In order to manage all the replication, there is even a MySQL Server database running on that server. You need to do is a very basic configuration. Guys, very important, you need to set up the credentials. Okay, the credentials is every time when you are about to connect a Windows machine to do the replication. Of course, the whole system or the configuration server needs to know what's the username and password. And when you are connecting the Linux machine, you need to provide what are the credentials for the Linux machines as well. And, just kind of, keep going on that. Some other configuration. And as I said, I skipped, I'm talking about maybe easily, I don't know, maybe 12 or maybe 15 steps. Not the end of the world, but kind of, a couple of steps to steps to be done. And then eventually, when they are done, finally, okay, you are able now to go back to the site recovery, and then eventually, as quickly I showed before, select on-prem to Azure, and then, there you go. You have your configuration server, available from there, and then from there you are able to basically pick the servers and carry on the replication from there. Okay, as quickly I said before, initially when you are looking to do the site recovery from VMware, seems very complicated, but it makes kind of, it becomes much, much, much easier if you just do it yourself. Okay, download that template, have a VMware host ready to go, and then, get things sorted. It's not too complicated. Okay, guys, and then eventually the last step is to set up to do the replication from a physical server. Okay, pretty much same story again. We go to the template, we go to the Azure, select Azure, and then now the type, as you can see here, is a physical machine. Same story, guys. When you select the physical machine, you will be prompt to download an agent. Okay, download that agent, okay, install in one of your computers. When the agent is fully up and running on that computer, there you go. And then next time, when you go back to your Azure subscription, you are able to see all the physical hosts, okay, from where that agent, is running. And then is matter to kind of, just follow the steps. Okay, to select what you want to replicate, and then eventually, just kind of, push the button, and then you will have that thing kind of replicated to Azure. And then, guys, the same procedure, okay, I think it's better for me to go here. The same procedure, when you have a physical computer now replicated, fully replicated to Azure. Okay, same story. The step number one would do would be to do a test failover, as I quickly told you before. Okay, the idea is to start that VM in a testing network when you are happy with the outcome, and then you could do the plan failover. Okay, the plan failover, as the name kind of, you know, suggests, the VM will be started on your Azure production network and the local computer will be shut down. Okay, and yeah, basically take from there. In an unplanned failover, of course, you know, is the suddenly the VM went down, and then you need to do the failover kind of, you know, you can schedule that thing to be automatically, and so on. And I think I haven't told you, of course, guys, when if it was a kind of partial problem on your local network, later on you can always, when things are back up and running, you can do the fail back, okay, to bring whatever are the new data on Azure to bring back to your local computer. Okay, actually, yeah, the next step is just a quick kind of picture, okay, from one of the tests when I did, okay, the fail back, as you can see, okay, now things are replicating from Azure back to my local server. Okay, guys, that is it, okay, pretty much. Just before we go, okay, yeah, 1 second, I will answer that quick question. Okay, 1 second, Mark, just before we go, guys, yeah, here is regarding the network, okay, because you need to do, you really need to be on top, and you need to understand the networking, and then I have 2 slides, and then we are kind of, you know, sorted. Okay, the first one is, as you can see, just let me get here a pen, okay, 1 second, guys, please, initially I told you, if you have your servers running in a different VLAN, okay, from where your workstations are running from, is much easier, okay? As you can see here, I have my local server under 192.168 something, and then I have my networks on Azure, okay, running on 172.16 something, and then I have a third site, maybe I could leave that thing out, but yeah, you know, running on 10. And then, guys, from a routing table point of view, the only thing I need to do pretty much is to make sure, okay, my local router, my VPN server is able to route packets designated to 172 to Azure. Okay, and then, you know, that will be my kind of day-to-day configuration. Now the thing is, eventually, when things happen, and let's say my whole local server here, okay, now is gone, okay, because I've been using the replication to my recovery network, okay, now it means the servers, they are already up and running, and then, guys, as you can see, they are already up and running in my recovery network under 192.168.1. Pretty much the only thing I need to do is to go to my local router here on-prem and say, okay, now that's fair enough. If anybody is looking, okay, to reach the network 192.168.1 anything, this network is not available locally anymore, and then basically you need to go to Azure. And then, of course, you know, Azure eventually will find that destination network. Guys, of course, if you are looking maybe to do the failover only for a couple of servers, as if you have done a couple of work on the routing table, okay, we can do a routing table that points for a whole network, like here, 192.168.1, anything, or of course, we can basically deal with routing table for a specific VM, or for a specific host. But anyway, guys, that will be a kind of much longer conversation. But as quickly I said, things are not like, oh yeah, like magic, you know, just push the button, now the VMs are running, they are up and running on Azure. The problem is, okay, that's fair enough, but how can these local computers now, okay, be able to eventually reach my servers who are running now from the Azure, not from my local local computer, okay, anymore. Okay, anyway, maybe do a bit of more kind of research, okay, on top of that. Okay, and then, guys, just trying to be on time here. Hopefully you are learning a couple of things. Guys, what I would recommend for you now is, yeah, please, especially if you've never done any particular site recovery, go ahead. The first thing you need to do is, you know, hopefully in a few minutes you will get the you know, our kind of free subscription. Guys, go ahead and just set up a new, just to avoid the problems, guys, the best thing to do is set up a new Microsoft Live account. Okay, on that new Microsoft Live account, do the Azure registration. Okay, and then, you know, go there and set up the vault and everything. If you want to do some labs on Hyper-V and you don't want to mess up your own environment, yeah, you can easily download those 180 days evaluation copy, install Hyper-V, install the agent, and, you know, job done. If you are looking to do a VMware lab, yeah, you need to install the VMware ESX. You know, there is a demo copy for that. vCenter as well. Install those guys. Okay, and then download, as quickly I showed you before, download the configuration server from, you know, the Azure. And when you have the configuration server, do the quick configuration, and then eventually job done. And guys, to be honest, if you want to have, let's say, as quick as possible, you know, a result in front of you, how to do the failover, how to do the test failover, and things like that, and then definitely the easiest way, the quickest way, is to do the Azure to Azure failover. Okay, and then you don't need anything locally configured, and with the subscription, sorry, with the credits we will give you in a few minutes, you can do that easily in kind of a couple of minutes. Okay, fair enough. Guys, that's it pretty much. Okay, thanks very much for, you know, connecting and to spend this last hour, okay, with me. Swellen, maybe if you could provide on the chat box the seminar evaluation. Okay, that is a quick survey. And then, guys, if you are looking maybe for a couple of other subjects, we could run, you know, some new seminars. That would be, you know, really...